I have this look that I want to show you guys how I did, and since I am kind of in a hurry, we're just gonna jump right into the video. So I picked up a few products when I went to Ulta the other day, and I restocked on my Precise My Brow pencil, and this one is in the shade 4. I also picked up a similar one, but this one is by Revlon. And this is the Colorstay brow pencil that comes with a spoolie on the one tip and then the product on the other end. This product here, I've never used before, but I'm really wanting to try this because I keep using mascara as like a gel. This is gonna be perfect so that I don't have to keep using mascara on my brows. It's got a really, really nice fine spoolie, which is gonna help to comb out my brows very good. So this is a tinted brow gel, and I believe this is in the medium shade. Yeah, medium brown. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna comb through them, and I might do a little bit after as well, but I wanna do this before to help them set, to help them separate, and then afterwards I'll go in with the product. And then I'm gonna take my Precise My Brow pencil, and I'm just gonna outline the bottom of my brow. Kind of like at the same time flicking it up to give the illusion of more hairs. So I have a scar here because I recently, actually yesterday, I got off my car and apparently we parked like really close to a tree right next to our parking spot. And when I got off, I guess I wasn't paying attention. And I like turned around like that, and that freaking branch like scratched my head pretty bad. I guess I was just lucky it didn't like go into my eye, because that could have been really bad. That's probably karma for always making fun of other people that run into things or trip or fall. When I was in, I think it was like maybe sixth grade, there was this kid in our class who we were outside like in the playground, and it was during lunch, and he ran into a tree, and I remember I was cracking up so bad. And actually every time that I think about it, I still laugh so hard. I doubt he watches these videos, but I guess I didn't think about it then, like how like embarrassed and bad he probably felt that I was making fun of him. I just remember like really having such a good laugh about it. And then he had a scar too, like he actually had, you know, like a scar from it. So every time that I would see it, I would still, like, I would remember again, and then I would laugh again. It's pretty bad. Yeah. But yeah, that's me. Always making fun of other people when they hurt themselves. So it's karma for like 15 years ago. So when I was at Ulta, I picked up a couple things. One thing that I really wanted to try was a different concealer, and I wanted to try Shape Tape, but there was a time that I went into Ulta and I tried to get matched for a shade for my concealer, and the girl there pretty much said that Shape Tape wasn't really for me. Like, she didn't think that any of the shades there would match me. They were either too light or too pink or something. She didn't really recommend it for me. So ever since then, I've been kind of curious to try it still, but I picked up this one here. And this is by LA Girl. It's Pro Concealer. It's the Pro Concealer. And I'm just gonna try it out today and see if I like it. I think I put too much. I'll try to bring some over to this side. I'm just taking my Airspun powder and I'm gonna set my concealer with this real quick. I'm also gonna take the concealer and apply it on the top. This concealer so far seems like it's pretty good. It's easy to apply. The applicator makes it so that you don't have to use a brush or anything. And it doesn't, you have a lot of control like on how much product you're using, so it doesn't take out a lot of product if you don't want it, you know, obviously if you don't want it to. And it kind of blends it out pretty good too. Now I'm just gonna add a little bit more of the brow tint. And just mainly here, like in the inner part of the brow. So I'm gonna add some tape just because I want, especially like the liner part, to look really straight. So yeah, now that I've got that on there, I'm gonna go ahead and take a really light shade from my Morphe palette. I'm taking this really light nude shade and I'm just gonna add this to the top part of my lid. Then I think I'm gonna take this shade here, which is pretty light as well, but it's got a little bit of like gray tones to it. So I'm just lightly adding it here. And the next shade that I'm thinking of taking is from the Anastasia Subculture palette. I swear I butchered that name on my last video so many times. Subculture. It's not that hard. I think I just glanced at it and then kind of just went from there and assumed that that's just how it was the whole entire time. So I'm taking Mercury. And this color is actually identical to the color of my shirt. So I'm just kind of placing it here and then I'll slowly blend it out. Okay, so I'm gonna go back in with the concealer and I'm gonna do the cut crease part. I'm gonna try it with this and see how this works. But if this is not, I'm kind of afraid that this is not going to, so I'm gonna probably end up going back in with my more defined brush. But I'll try it. That was actually not bad at all. Just gonna try to blend it out now because I think I have a lot of product. Oh. So now that I have that part there, I'm gonna take a brush and just pick up some loose powder and set this concealer. Now taking my Stila eyeliner. And I'm just gonna remove the tape and see how it's looking. For now, I'm gonna move on to my lashes, and where did they go? I'm just gonna use my Sasha Lashes by Huda Beauty. So I'm just gonna apply these real quick and I'll be right back. So my eyelashes are semi done. I still need to add some mascara to the bottom. I forgot to put it before, and then I'm just gonna clamp them together with my lash curler. For my foundation today, I'm going to be taking the Fenty Beauty, and this is the Fenty primer that goes with it. My Sephora, every time that I go in, is always out of stock of her products. So I ordered it. They ordered it for me online, but they also gave me some samples so that I can use for meanwhile. So I got the primer and the foundation. So I'm just applying the primer all over. I've had the foundation before. I really like it. I'm not necessarily like trialing it out. It's just that every time I go, they're always out. So I hadn't been able to restock on it. But this primer is really nice. It feels like a lotion, almost like a thick lotion. This isn't like a silicone based primer like the professionals one that I usually use. So I'm gonna be wearing shade 190. Yeah, that looks about right. This is the one that I ordered, so I really hope that I like the shade. I think it oxidizes a little bit, so it might turn a little bit darker. So I'm just gonna blend it out. So this is a really nice medium to full coverage foundation, and I think I really want to go for like a full coverage today. So I'll probably come back and add a little bit more, but I'm gonna add one layer for now. I'm going back in with the concealer. And I'm just gonna blend it all out as usual. Then I'm gonna add setting powder. So now I'm just gonna add some mascara to my top lashes, and I'm gonna crimp them together. So to the bottom lashes, I'm gonna add some glitter, and this is by NYX. This is called Liquid Crystals Body Liner. So I'm just gonna apply this right by the lower lashes, and then I'm gonna apply mascara right over. So that's pretty much it on the eyes. This next product I'm going to be taking is this palette that I got also from Ulta. They were having this sale where if you purchase a certain amount, I can't remember if it was like 55 or 45 or something like that, you got the gift bag. It's just the bag here. It's pretty cool. It's got like the floating little pieces of whatever they are in there, and then you get like a free brow pencil. This is kind of like the Precise My Brow, but this is Goof Proof Brow Pencil. It's just the mini version of it. I think really it just doesn't have like the spoolie. And then I think there was also one other thing that came with it. Oh, this one here, which is the What's Up highlighter. I tried it. It's pretty good. But I'm really, really excited for this product here. This is Pretty in the USA. And basically what this is it has a bronzer, a blush, and a highlight. This is the Hoola bronzer that I use all the time. So I know I'm gonna love that one. this bronze, the blush has a little bit of a shimmer in it, and then of course the highlight. So I don't know about the blush, but I'm definitely gonna go ahead and try this out and see how I feel about it. So I'm gonna go ahead and take my blush brush by Real Techniques, and I'm just gonna start with the bronzer, and I'm just gonna apply this here like I usually do. Next, I'm gonna take some blush and apply this right over the bronzer. It's actually scented. It's really scented. It smells good. So that looks really pretty. Even though it's got a little bit of a shimmer, which I'm not really used to, but so it's not that bad. It's just a little bit of shimmer. And then for a little bit of highlight, I'm just gonna spray my brush with a little Fix Plus. So I'm just gonna go ahead and dip it in here, and I'm gonna apply it right over the blush. Looks really pretty. Next, I'm just gonna take another smaller brush to pick up highlight for my Cupid's bow. It's a really light highlight. It's not like really, really pigmented. So adding the Fix Plus does make it a little bit more intense, but honestly, it's not all that great. I'm adding some to my nose. See, it's not so great, honestly. It's not as pigmented as I would want it to be. As I expected it to be, especially being a Benefit product. Okay, so because I really want my inner corners to glow, honestly, I'm just gonna take my Dirty Revolution palette, because I do like this highlight a little bit better. I'm gonna use this to highlight the inner corner of my eyes. Yeah, that works a lot better, and I didn't even have to wet the brush anymore. So I'll probably go over some of the highlight with this one. So now to the last part, which is lipstick. This is a new shade that I picked up from MAC, and this is the color Whirl. It's a light, I know it looks pretty dark, but it's like this is my type of nude. It's pretty brown. Forget that I said nude. And I kind of just outlined my lips with this brush a little bit more to give it a more defined look. All right, guys, well, this is it for today's look. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please make sure to give it a thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel if you were not already subscribed. And I will see you guys in my next one.